Hello friends, in this video I'm going to tell you how to connect Nikon mirrorless camera Z50 or for that matter any mirrorless Nikon camera with respect to Wi-Fi to a PC. So all we require is downloading an app, Nikon Wireless Transmitter Utility. So I have just typed in the search here. You can see it is available on the Nikon website, Wireless Transmitter Utility. So this app we must download on our desktop PC. So here it is, the web page. It takes us to a download page further. So we have to click here on the download page. It shows two options, either for Windows PC or Mac OS. So in my case it is a Mac OS. Down below we just have to select the region and do the download. So I'll just do that. So we can see that it is downloaded. Let me open it and quickly we can go for installing this particular software. Let us install this on our PC. These are usual steps to be followed on Mac operating system. Just click next and click install. It will take us to these steps. We'll just agree and click install. Enter your password for the PC before you install the software. So Wireless Transmitter Utility must be first installed on our laptop or PC. We can see it is installed now. Let us go and check on the computer. Right side, Wireless Transmitter Utility, let us launch it. So it gives option to pair the computer with the camera. Click next. Then select camera built-in Wi-Fi. And then select the destination folder where you would like to save the images transferred from the camera over to the PC. So I'll just browse and create a folder on my desktop. I'll just name this folder as images. So let me create a new folder. Let us name it as images. And click create. So the folder is created on my desktop. Then we, after selecting the folder in this app, we just click further, click next, and the wizard is finished. Before transferring the image, we need to pair the camera with our PC over camera Wi-Fi network. Switch on your camera and please go to the setup menu. So let us check. This is now camera interface I am showing here on the screen. I'll go to the setup menu. Within setup menu we have to scroll down all the way to the third page in order to check with the connection to PC of option. So let us scroll further. The various items are there in the setup menu, but we need to scroll down until we reach connect to PC option. So here we'll select this one, click OK on the camera, and it will bring us to this window, and we can see Wi-Fi connection is currently off. We go to the network settings in order to configure our desktop or laptop with respect to the camera. So move down to create profile. We have to add the PC with the camera in order to pair it. So I click on create profile, and then there are two options, either search for a Wi-Fi network or direct connection to the PC. So I choose the second option, direct connection to PC. So it will tell me that I should look for the camera Wi-Fi network over my PC and put the key as indicated down at the bottom. So again I move to my PC, search for the available networks over Wi-Fi. So we can see down at the bottom the Z50 camera network is visible now. We'll click on it. It will ask for the key provided on the camera screen. So I'll read from camera screen and enter this key. So it's a sort of a password for pairing. I'll just click join and I'll be able to join the Wi-Fi setup by the camera. Please remember, I am not using the camera of my home. I'm using the camera network of a Wi-Fi network of camera. Okay. So here we can see now we are connected to Z50 network, Nikon Z50 camera network. Now what we have to do is refer to the camera screen. It will tell us to initiate the pairing request with the camera through the PC. Okay. So let us check with the camera screen. It shows pairing computer with the camera. So we have to restart the wireless transmitter utility on the PC or laptop. So again, once you are in a camera Wi-Fi network, start the wireless transmitter utility app on the computer. So let me launch it. As soon as I launch it, this time it will show the available camera as Z50. I'll select and click next. It will ask for one authentication code. So camera will show the authentication code on its screen as visible here in the screenshot. So I'll put the code here in the app on computer and click next, and it shows pairing is completed. So now my PC is paired with the camera over camera's Wi-Fi network. Then click next. Okay. So destination folder and all we have already selected earlier. Again click next, and it shows that the action is completed successfully. Again we can just click next and see the further process, how this camera will be able to transfer the images. As soon as we click here next on this particular app, it will also be indicated on the camera screen that pairing has been completed. So let us check with the camera screen. It will show that pairing process is completed from either side after we have entered the authentication code. So it shows pairing complete. We just have to click OK on the camera. And now what we have to do is that we have to configure the camera Wi-Fi connection. We have to set it and see that down below, now my camera shows that Wi-Fi connection is established, that green highlight is visible. I should always keep the Wi-Fi connection on the camera while I want to transfer the images to the PC. So it shows Wi-Fi connection on. Next thing, I have to check that auto send option is enabled. So I go to the options for enabling the other settings related to transfer. You can see auto send default, it is indicating that it is set to on. Okay. There are various other options, whether you would like to delete after sending and what should be the format of images that are to be transferred and other options. But we are interested mainly in setting auto send into on mode. So in my case, it is already in the on mode, but if it is not, then one must set it to auto send mode. So we are ready. Now let us switch on the camera and check some of the images which are taken on the camera, and then those images we would like to transfer over Wi-Fi all the way to my PC and just check whether they are getting transferred easily or not. So these are some of the images. I am just showing the screen of my camera. They are stored on my camera. These are the images, right? Now let us check whether they are getting transferred to my camera over Wi-Fi or not. So again, I come to my PC and I launch the images folder which I created earlier on the desktop. Okay, so here it is. This folder is there. There are several embedded folders inside this images folder. So I should go into camera, then DCIM, and then Z15. So one of the images is already resting here. Now what I do is that I will connect again back to the camera Wi-Fi network. Earlier I have shown that it was connected, it was paired. Okay. But now again I will connect it and check whether the images are getting transferred. So we can see here the images are getting transferred from camera over Wi-Fi to my PC one by one. So this way we can successfully transmit the images. And every time I just switch off the camera network or my PC network to some other Wi-Fi, I'll be able to restore the connection just by selecting camera network, enabling it, and whatever new images are taken, they will be automatically transferred to my PC and I don't need to do any wired connection with it. So thank you very much. I hope you are able to understand and you are able to use it for your benefit. Thanks.